Hey everyone, welcome back to Heartway Farms. Today we wanted to share with you one of our very favorite recipes that Julianne makes, and it's our homemade cream puffs. So let's get started. So we are here at the stove, and the first thing you want to do is preheat our oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. And I have my cast iron pan. It doesn't have to be cast iron. Okay, a little disclaimer. I have made up this recipe for the most part, so the measurements, they're a little strange, so just pay attention. But it has been perfected, so don't deviate. So what I'm going to do is put 3/4 plus 1/3 cup of water in my pan, and this is just regular filtered water. So it's 3/4 and 1/3, and what I'm going to do is put this on like medium high heat, and then I have my butter, and this is just 1 stick of butter, so 8 tablespoons. I've just chopped it up to help it break down a little quicker as it heats up. And then what we're just going to do is let this all kind of melt together. Eventually, you're gonna want it to come to a simmer. Sliding away. And then here I have 1 tablespoon of cane sugar and 1 teaspoon of sea salt. And I'm just going to add that into my water with my butter. And now really, I'm just gonna sit here and stir this gently until everything melts down. And you're gonna want it to come to a light simmer. Not a rolling boil, just barely bubbling. Okay, so this is just barely bubbling now, and what I'm going to do is just turn off the heat. Let's stop bubbling for a second. And then I'm going to pour in my flour, and I have 3/4 cup plus 1/3 cup of flour. And you just want to gently stir this in without exploding flour everywhere, like I tend to do. And it'll be very thick. This is going to be, it's kind of more of a roux right now until we add the eggs later. Okay, I have combined this mostly. There's still little bits of flour in there that haven't gotten mixed in completely, but that's okay. And what I'm going to do is put my heat on again. I've got it like medium high, and I'm just gonna let that cook the flour for just 1 minute, not very long. You just wanna keep stirring it so it doesn't stick to the pan. You can see it's really, really smooth and buttery. And it actually tastes really good like this. At least I think so. Some of the kids are not huge fans. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna turn off the heat, and I'm gonna go bring this to my mixer. I'm just gonna pour this into my kitchen. Can you grab that?
Yep. There we go. I got it. Do you want any of that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cast iron pans are great. They're just kind of heavy.
Yeah, you work your muscles when you have a cast iron.
Okay. Then I'm just gonna fit my paddle attachment onto here. And I'm gonna let it slowly mix. What I'm gonna do is let this cool for about 5 minutes, just so we don't cook the eggs when they go in there.
While it's mixing?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm gonna let it do this for like 5 minutes. Okay, so this has been cooling for a little while. I'm gonna go ahead and turn that off. Just let it sit for a second. And I'm going to crack 3 eggs into a separate container.
this is probably pretty obvious, but the reason why you can't put the eggs in when the dough is so warm, it will cook your eggs as opposed to incorporating your eggs. So you don't really want scrambled eggs in your pate choux dough because that's no good. Mm. Nobody likes that.
And you're going to want to incorporate these one at a time and let it thoroughly mix in before you add your other egg. So I've got this on low again, and I'm just going to let one of my eggs go in.
And the goal is to slowly mix in all three eggs one at a time.
Yep. I'm gonna do my other one. I'm gonna go ahead and scrape down the sides of this real quick.
These cream puffs are one of my favorite recipes that Julianne makes, and I usually only get them when guests are in town because she got so tired of making them all the time for us and for the bakery and different things like that, that she's like, Mom, I don't want to. I'm like, they're my favorite. You got to make them. So I usually get them on special occasions or when people are staying with us from out of town or we're making it for an event or something. But they are so good. And they stay for several days in the fridge, which is nice too. So you can make them a couple days ahead of time if you have an event coming up. And we have, you were going to say, we have been told that we've never had to freeze them, but we've been told that you can freeze them, defrost mm-hmm. them and serve them as well. So that's good to know.
Yes.
All right, so third egg is in.
Yep. And mixing. As you can see, it's getting like nice and glossy. There's still a couple little chunks in there, but it's all coming together.
Well, it makes a beautiful cream yellow colored dough, which is beautiful for pate choux.
Scrape this down again.
And in the summer months when, the chickens are on pasture, it makes just beautiful yellow mm-hmm. dough with that bright yellow yolks in the summertime. Right now we're in the middle of winter, so not as yellow as they normally would be, but.
Still not too bad.
No, it looks really good.
Okay, I think that's good.
Nice and incorporated.
Nice and creamy, glossy. The eggs in it make it really glossy. Sticky.
Yeah, it is a very sticky dough.
Our dough is finished, and I'm just going to transfer it into our piping bag. And Mom, do you want to throw together an egg wash for us?
Yes, the egg wash is for in a little bit. Ooh, that is a strong eggshell.
Yeah, healthy chickens. Healthy chickens
okay.
out there.
It's like Fort Knox there. Okay, I'm going to put this over here.
And I'm using just a large piping bag. You can use a large plastic baggie. I just like the piping bags better when I'm making cream puffs usually.
They don't break on
yes.
you. We have had Ziploc bags
all over it too.
Break, but these nice thick ones are more dependable for that. Okay, so I'm making this egg wash to put on the top once she does this next step, and you guys will see it. And the egg wash gives the top of the cream puffs just a beautiful golden color, so that's why you want that. I will also get you a brush.
Yes.
Brush.
Okay. I'm gonna gather this all together. I'm gonna twist the top just to secure it so it doesn't explode on me. And I'm going to snip off the tip of this. I'm probably gonna do, I don't know.
Just about an inch off?
Inch. There we go. And this makes 12. And what I like to do is actually make 12 like half size ones first and then go over again and do 12 on top of those just so I make sure and get them nice and evenly distributed. So there's like not one cream puff that's twice the size of all the other ones.
So you're creating a portion,
yes.
a portion system. So you're gonna do 12 dollops. Yeah, I've even seen you go back like a third time just if you're just trying to get 12 even cream puffs so that they bake evenly, they are the same size, especially if you're making them for people, you know, for other people, and they're uniformed. So here she's just making sure they're all pretty even. And you know what's fun with this recipe is that you can make, this recipe either makes 12 full-size cream puffs, and you'll see they, once they're filled, they get nice and full, and it's a great portion. Or you all the time for get-togethers and parties and stuff, you make minis.
Yeah, especially for like baby showers, wedding
showers.
Yeah,
it's been really fun. And you can do different colors of toppings. But anyway, we're showing you our favorite way to do it, and that's to make 12 full-size cream puffs. But you can absolutely do the same thing that she's doing in this step, just make them smaller. So this also makes 24 minis, and they're like two bites. They're perfect for little appetizer type
like
things,
the
or finger desserts.
Yes. Equivalent of cream puffs.
Absolutely. But these look beautiful, and you've got 12 even sized dough portions, and now you're doing the egg wash.
Yes.
So gentle egg wash just to get that beautiful color.
You definitely try not to squish them down, like you just want to barely
no
touch
squishing.
Them with the
brush. Baby, don't squish. You want to baby your pate choux dough, for sure. It is a little finicky.
But worth it.
It's worth it, yes.
Once you figure it out.
Yeah. But we've even had issues doubling this recipe. I know that people will ask this question, but you can try it. We have had success sometimes with doubling, and we have also not had success with doubling. So we have decided that just making single recipes multiple times is the way to go with this recipe. I don't know why necessarily, whether it's the oven or whether it's the eggs, you know, the freshness of the eggs that we are using. I mean, these eggs are from today, so they're very fresh, but we have had issues with doubling. So I don't really recommend it. Even though you're gonna want a double recipe because they're so good.
I make the 24 minis, so it seems like.
Yes, yeah, so you seem like you're eating more. Yeah, that's right. Okay. So you're done with these.
Yep.
These are going in the oven at, go ahead.
425 degrees, and I'm gonna do that for 5 minutes, and then I'm gonna turn the oven down to 375 degrees,
yep.
And I'm gonna do that for another half an hour.
So 5 minutes first,
yep.
And then your lower temp at 30. Don't forget them in the oven at the high temp. All right, let's do it.
So our cream puffs have been baking for 5 minutes, and now I'm just going to bring the temperature down to 375 degrees, and then they're going to bake for another half an hour. And you really don't want to open up your oven at all in this portion. Just don't let any of the heat out. Puffs are done. I'm just sliding them off the parchment paper right now. So yes, we're just gonna let this cool until they're completely 100% cooled, and then we can fill them and then frost them. So while our shells are cooling, I'm going to throw together our chocolate frosting. So I have 1 stick of butter, 8 tablespoons, and I just chopped it up. I have 4 tablespoons of milk, and I mixed in my vanilla in there with it, so I have 4 tablespoons of milk and 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. And I have 4 tablespoons of cocoa powder. And now what I'm gonna do with this is I'm going to actually just put it in the microwave. You can do it on the stove very slowly. I've always just preferred microwaving it. And I'm going to put it in for like 15-second, 20-second intervals, and I'm just going to mix it with a fork in between to make sure it doesn't burn. And I'll be back in a bit. Okay, so my stuff is melted. You can see it's melted completely. And I'm just going to pour it into my mixer. And now I'm going to put in 3 cups of powdered sugar. Very carefully, till this goes. Powdered sugar dust. It smells so good.
Okay, now I'm just going to very carefully mix this. Oh, it smells so good. This is actually my grandma's Texas sheet cake frosting recipe. And it is literally the best chocolate frosting ever.
Well, yeah, because
it's so good.
When we began researching cream puff recipes, which again, she has tweaked this and made this completely her own with the proper portions and different things like that. Mm. It's just so much better than anything else we had tried previously. But other frostings are just okay.
Better. Most of them don't even have frosting. This is usually like an
chocolate
eclair thing.
Yeah, it's like an eclair thing. So we serve our cream puffs with chocolate drizzle or solid chocolate frosting on top. And once you try it, you won't go back either. So it looks beautiful. Good job. So the frosting is done. Yep. The cream puff shells are done. The last thing that we will do once these are completely cool is show you guys how to make homemade whipped cream. Mm-hmm. Super easy, but you can't beat it. It's like the best. So we'll check back in with you guys after everything is ready to go. Okay, these are cool all the way, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now we have our frosting made, our cream puff shells are good, and we're moving on to our homemade whipped cream. The best whipped cream is homemade whipped cream. All right, so talk us through it.
So we have 2 cups of heavy whipping cream.
And I use store-bought heavy cream for a nice, stiff whipped cream to fill these. If we're just making it to dip strawberries in or something, you can use raw milk, you know, the cream on the top. But for this recipe, I want something super stiff, so we use store-bought heavy whipping cream. Okay, go ahead, sorry.
Can I have a towel?
Yes. This is mess prevention that I appreciate greatly.
So we just have a towel and we're just going to
because it will splatter.
And we're gonna let this whip.
On high, let it go, let it get nice and thick, and we'll come back when it's done.
Okay, so our whipped cream is done.
It was whipping for about 1 minute and 30 seconds. I was trying to keep track so that we could tell people how long it took.
You can see it's super, like, super fluffy. Yeah. And I'm gonna have to put that back on there.
But you can see if it stays, if it holds over her head, you know, if you hold it, then you know you're okay. All right, go ahead.
Okay. Now, okay, so I have 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract.
Gotta have vanilla in your whipped cream, just my opinion.
And 1 cup of powdered sugar.
Here, I'll take dishes.
And I'm just gonna do this until it's just combined. Just keep it on low because it's flying out. Yep.
While that's incorporating, I have another piping bag here. Actually, this is the same piping bag that we used for the batter. And I just cleaned it out because I didn't want to waste it. So now this time for the whipped cream, we want a piping tip. You don't have to do this, but it makes it easier when you're trying to fill your cream puffs to insert a metal tip into the middle to be able to do it. So like I said, at the end of this large piping bag, we cut that off. And now we're gonna put the tip in the bottom. All right, I might need to, actually it's okay. Good. We want it fitted, nice and tight. All right, go ahead.
And then what I like to do, just to make sure it doesn't come out the bottom, is just to twist it like 3 or 4 times.
And what I like to do is taste the whipped cream to make sure it's okay. It's okay. Delicious.
Good.
No one will be upset by that.
Then I just like to use the cup to hold it up for me. Get it down in there.
Now you want it down there.
Yeah.
In the
you still want it exploding. And I'm gonna twist up the top too.
Otherwise it'll explode out the top.
No exploding.
No exploding whipped cream.
I'm just going to very carefully go in the side and then fill. I like to keep my whole hand around it because then I can feel when it starts to get full. And then you want to fill until you feel just before, or even I did that one a little much, it started to burst at the top.
But they're beautifully filled, nice and thick and heavy. I do want to say one thing real quick. Don't be discouraged if your cream puff deflates a little bit. Can you see the difference in that? So this one did not deflate, this one did deflate just a little bit, not bad. But don't be discouraged by that because as soon as you put, here, watch this. As soon as you put the whipped cream in, it will bring it back to life and make it huge and beautiful and just as big as those that kept their shape. So anyway, don't be discouraged by that. If one, you can, it whipped cream covers a multitude of mistakes with your pate choux dough. Not that it just happens. It's a sensitive dough, and some are just kept are keeping their shape just perfectly. But if you get one that deflates, no big deal. You just fill it back up with whipped cream, and it looks just as beautiful as when it came out of the oven. Okay, these cream puffs look beautiful. They are full of whipped cream. Julianne did a great job. Now it's time for the frosting. Like I said, you can eat them just like this if you want to, but we like them with either solid chocolate frosting or drizzle frosting. We made our chocolate frosting ahead of time, and sometimes it will stiffen back up. It's easy. All you have to do is, how long do you microwave it for?
10 seconds.
10 seconds just to loosen it back up and make it spreadable, and sometimes you have to do that throughout the process too, depending on how long it takes. So it's super easy to work with frosting, no big deal, and now you're gonna top them, right?
Yes. So what I'm just gonna do is, for this part, I like to do a spoon. I just get a little bit of the frosting to put it on top and just kind of
work it
on the top. Yeah. And really, you can do just as much or as little frosting as you would like. There we go.
This, in this part, it's nice because when you're looking at the cream puffs, you can see all the different shapes. Some of these that have texture on top make it very hard to do a solid chocolate top. We save those for drizzle.
Yes.
So when she does the drizzle portion, which she'll get to this, she will make sure the frosting is a little bit looser so you can get a nice drizzle over the top. During this part, it doesn't really matter. It can be a little bit thicker. It can be, and this just depends on how much you want. Some people request only solid tops, and some people request only drizzle tops. It just depends on how much frosting you like. But we like doing half and half because you can choose, and it's nice if you don't like a lot of frosting, you do the drizzle top, no big deal. Okay, she softened up the frosting just a little bit. Got it? And then
I got a fork instead of a spoon.
Enough where it can drip real pretty. And this is just fun. It makes it, it's just a real fun, delicate design to put on top of your cream puff. Looks really nice. And delicious. All right, the cream puffs are filled and beautiful. Julianne did a fantastic job, as always. It's a favorite dessert around here that I don't get as much as I wish I could get. But a couple things, we recommend storing them in the fridge. You can make them ahead of time and enjoy them. You know, you can make them a day or two ahead of time, and they are just as good as fresh. And all I recommend is if you're storing them in the fridge, and let's say you have an event coming up or a get together or whatever that you're serving them at, bring them back to room temperature about an hour before you're gonna eat them. They're good cold, but I like them just melt in your mouth, delicious. So anyway, they look great. Now I have dessert to eat tonight for no reason at all. Sometimes it's fun just to have dessert because you can have dessert.
So Dad will be happy when he's
yeah, and Josh will enjoy them tomorrow. So. Anyway, we hope you enjoyed this video. Try out this recipe at home. Make sure you tag us in social media when you do try it and show it. I love seeing what you guys are up to trying our recipes. And make sure you also hit that subscribe button, share us with your family and friends, and we'll see you all in the next video.